Online shopping may be easy, but it's growing at the expense of brick-and-mortar retailers, from your mom-and-pop neighborhood shop, even to the big box stores. Here with a closer look at what stores are doing to adapt is marketing expert Tony Chapman. Good to see you.
Good to be here, always.
So tell us about this shift and what's happening.
Well, I understand why we're moving online. You know, a cash-starved, time-starved consumer, it's very convenient. What I'm concerned with is sort of from a social conscious point of view is what happens as we move kind of from bricks to clicks in terms of our main streets, our malls, jobs, our economy. Canada, it has a massive impact when we start thinking about going to face-to-face shopping to simply going online.
You say that there are three types of shopping experiences and how that kind of delves into this whole situation.
Yeah, I mean, you've got people that are just, you know, pure play. I only shop face-to-face. I love being with people. There's people that have kind of hybrid, a combination of the two, which most Canadians are at. And then there's people now that are really just going, I'm pretty well putting most of my spending online. I'm not talking about topping up for groceries, but most of my big spending
is done online.
And the problem being is that the bricks, the retailers in the malls and on Main Street are at a real cost disadvantage. I mean, they got to pay rent, they got to pay local taxes, they got to employ people, they got to dress their windows, on and on and on. And so when we start shifting more and more of our dollars online, they're in a very precarious position. And we're seeing that not just the little stores closing, but also, you know, we've seen some major chains
that we've
lost on our watch. Amazon, Walmart recently, you know, starting to close stores.
Yeah, Walmart Express we saw in the States closing 102 stores. And what happens, Tony, when those big anchor stores like the Walmarts and the Targets, you know, go out of business? What happens to the smaller stores around?
Well, that's what happens. I mean, first of all, the mall, if you lose your anchor tenants, you know, and nothing comes in to replace it, very quickly the whole psychology of shopping that mall changes. Or if you lose sort of the tier one stores and all of a sudden you're going more of the discount stores, that you go, this isn't the same mall, I don't have the same energy. Same thing happens on Main Street. I mean, you go walk down Main Street, which is so important for the culture of your neighborhood, the magic of it, the property values, and you suddenly go and that store's boarded up, or now it's a massage parlor, or services like dentistry. It has a very different feel than where you used to, almost as a promenade, meander up Main Street, get your coffee, your baguette, hey, I'm going to go in and buy a dress. When those dress shops and the color of that disappears, a lot of the personality of Main Street goes with it.
What about Amazon and its effect?
Well, Amazon is so powerful. First of all, this guy's a genius. He understands the psychology of shopping. He started with low-hanging fruit books, and now he's taking you across every category. He doesn't really care about making money right now. He just wants to change the psychology of your behavior. He wants to get you so addicted to shopping in Amazon. It's like the world's biggest vending machine. And once he has you, he's just going to continue to do it. But in its path, I mean, the Amazon effect in the States, negative job losses over 150,000, you know, thousands upon thousands of stores that have gone out of business because it's so easy to just go on Amazon and buy.
Interesting to see this shift. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.